about the recording in the room. Okay, so first of all, I am going to open up Word. Okay, and this is some information that I got from one of the Delaware State websites on pensions. We all care about retirement. I thought it was a common theme. Okay, you may not know how to change this, or what I love is, by the way, in this sample, I'm using 2016. Everything that I tell you today works as well on 2013 or 2010. Okay, so the interface may look slightly different, but the features are the same. You can do the same thing. So right next to the question mark, okay, for help, that's where the controls are on how to show your ribbon or your tabs or things like that. In 2013, they were smart and they made it back to a question mark. Back in 2007, they made it look like a little roof of a house, and people would go over there for help and then collapse their ribbon at the same time because the phone rang, and now their ribbon's gone and it's broken. Okay, well, the thing I do to fix that is I close Word and I'll reopen it, right? And the ribbon's still gone. So just to let you know, they've gotten a little better. They have heard our cries of pain, and they say, okay, we'll make this from a menu now. A lot of people like a simpler view, and they'll just say, show my tabs. I don't need all that visual stimulation. That's your choice, okay? This is the quick access toolbar, and what I don't understand in Word is why spell check isn't automatically on the quick access toolbar. So quick access toolbar, there you go, spelling and grammar. So you don't have to go to the review ribbon, okay? You don't have to do that and go to spelling and grammar. It's right here now. The other thing you can do with this quick access toolbar is show it below the ribbon. So if you don't want to take up as much landscape, again with all those visuals, and you go to show tabs, now you have this little toolbar with all the things that you use. So maybe you change margins a lot. I can right click on any icon and add that to the quick access toolbar, and now it's at my fingertips. That's not just Word, that's Excel, that's PowerPoint. Quick access toolbar is global. And most of the things I'll be, hi, welcome. Most of the things I'll be talking about in Word are global, okay? Because it's just good things to know.
So you can do that right click in 2010?
Yes. Because the quick access toolbar, it does exist. Okay, you've probably never used it because it's silly. It starts off with the save. I love that the save icon is still a disc, you know? It's like, because like people that are 15 don't know what a disc is. And so I just feel like, you know, you don't know everything, right? History is important. The other thing that you can do is if you know there's a command and you can't find it on the ribbon, you can go to more commands, and you can go from popular to commands to all the commands. This is everything you can do in Word. You can add any one of those tools. Okay, so let's say I saw something about proofing, or I'll do protect document, that's fine. I'll just add that, and now it's on my toolbar. Okay, so if you know it's there, you can't figure out what ribbon it's on, that's another way to add it. Okay, to really customize your workflow and work more efficiently. That's for anybody. Okay? So does anybody have a problem with the fact that Calibri and 11 is the new font instead of Times New Roman 12? Okay, you hate it. Okay, well, that's completely fine. You can dislike it all you want. That's completely fine. What I want you to know is if you would like to change your font back to Times New Roman 12 permanently, so you'd never have to, like, every time you open the document, you're switching it, you go to this dialog box. Sorry, I clicked kind of fast. It's right here, okay? Each of the groups, you know, this is called a tab, then it opens a ribbon. These are groups and these are icons. In each group where they couldn't fit everything on the ribbon, they added the dialog box, which looks like, oh, back to 98, right? That really hasn't changed. That was like, because that's when they fit everything. So if we did Times New Roman and 12, I could set this as my default. Okay, I'm going to do it, and then I'm going to cancel out because I don't want to change my default. But you can do it for this document only, or you can change the normal template. So every time you open Word, it'll always be Times and 12. What's the other thing that's new that we don't like? Extra spacing after the paragraph?
Yeah,
Okay. All right. So paragraph has a group there too. And it'll have spacing. I think the default now is 8 points after, and it's a multiple of 1.08. So make the settings that you want. Maybe it's, you know, single spacing and no leader space or after space. You can do whatever you want and set it as the default. Okay? So you can make it the default for just this document or everything that you ever open again. So if that doesn't save you a little bit of time, I don't know what will. Okay, great. So now, what I did was I got this text from the website and I applied heading styles. So if you don't use heading styles, they're worth to know what they're about. It allows you to, all I did was I click styles in the styles group, okay? So I said, I selected this text and it used to say normal and I put it as heading one. That's it, okay? So then I can change this, and what happens is that it will change everywhere that the style is affected if I want. Let's say I would like this to be blue, okay? Now if I come up to heading style one, hi, come on in, you're fine. We update to match, and you see anywhere that heading style one is invoked, it now changes, okay? Yeah, there's plenty of room.
Thank you.
Sure, come on in. Okay, I have on show hide right now. Okay, the show hide button is in the paragraph group. If you don't know what show hide is, it's really uncomfortable to get used to, but it really helps you when you're dealing with, you know, oh, you're shaking your head. Why? Why is show hide helpful? What does it show you?
It shows you all the codes
that put in all the changes, breaks, so forth. Yeah. Good for you. Okay. So I want to encourage you to at least be comfortable switching back and forth. What show hide does is it shows you every time there's a paragraph return, every time there's a manual return, every time there's a tab, even every time there's a space. So if you see text out in the middle of the page, like this, turning on show hide lets you know how it got there. Okay? So I'm going to get rid of that because that just made my document ugly. All right? If I go to the view ribbon, one thing I do always like to have on is the ruler. Okay, here's our ruler. Any paragraph that we click on, we have this, the indentations going on. Okay, so right now everything is aligned to the left, but if I wanted that top line to indent, that's a really easy way to do it. Okay, and then from this point forward, as I typed more information, it would keep that same indenting. Because the text is already on the page, it's not going to change everything.
It didn't move the stuff below,
right? No, because I didn't have it selected, because it was already on the page. If I do Control A to select the whole page, then I can do it. But it's also going to affect my heading one style right now, because I've applied styles. Okay? But okay. That's a great observation.
How did you know to select heading to select the A?
Okay. So
is there nothing telling you?
There are a lot of shortcut keys, and if you want to make notes of those, you can. There are my favorite ones, and I put some of them on the website link that make sure you get a little bookmarker. If you want to go back, all these files are there if you want to play with them. But Control A is to select all. Control C is to copy. Okay. Control what is to paste?
V.
I'm so glad. What does P do? That's right. Everybody's made that mistake. Okay? So, see, you're way ahead of the game. You already know some great shortcuts. There is a whole list of shortcuts.
And you say it's in the website?
Yes. Uh-huh. Make sure you get a little bookmarker. You have it in your hand. Mm-hmm. Okay? Alrighty. So, there are some shortcut keys there, not everyone, but if you want it more, you can contact me. I'd be happy to do it. I can send you things. That's my website. It has a contact form. I answer everything. It's fine. Okay. So notice that I found a mistake in spelling on this website. I'm sure you don't maintain that. It's underlined in blue. Okay. Blue means that it is a questionable, not spelling, not grammar, but possibly word choice because employees is spelled right. Okay. If I ran spell check, I would see what it is. Basically, in this sentence, it's saying state employees possessive pension plan, okay, would be the corrected thing. Now, if you said state employee pension plan, well, that's kind of a name. Okay, so you still have to be a real person and check all this out. I'm watching my time. There is something I really want to show you. And I'm having so much time and fun in Word, but there are two things I want to show you. If you use heading styles, you can insert an automatic table of contents. Okay, let me zoom in so you can see that. Right now I have everything on page 1 or 2. I'm going to turn off the show hide so you don't see those little tweedly things. But it's based on heading styles. If I use heading style 1, 2, or 3, it will build my table of contents. Okay? Alrighty. Yes?
What is the shortcut after you write your document to automatically update the page numbers in the table of contents?
I don't know what the shortcut is. That's a good question.
What's the long cut?
Well, there you go. You click on the update table, okay, and then you update the entire table. And okay, and it would go out and double check all your heading styles and the location and rebuild the pages for you. I usually suggest to people not to worry about the table of contents until you get done. Okay? Also, don't worry about pagination until you get done. Now, speaking about pagination, the quick way to insert a page break is Control Enter, and that puts in a page break. It forces it to the next page. If you would like to have something different. You want to have the header and footer different in one section. You want to insert a landscape page. Okay? Instead of portrait, you want a big table. You need a section break. If you don't know the difference, it's worth doing a tutorial on it. And that is Control Shift Enter would give me a section break. Okay? I'm going to turn on Show Hide because that shows me, it actually said it was a column break, but that's okay. It'll do it as a section break as well. I'm going to go ahead and show you the other way in case you're not a shortcut key person. The breaks are all available from the page layout ribbon in the breaks group. And a section break is the next page. Okay, so I'm going to make a true section break to make sure that I get exactly what I want because I have all you watching. Okay, so for this section and this section only, I want to change the orientation to be landscape. Okay, so if I do it this way, it's going to change it from this point forward now. Do you see that? Let me zoom out so you can see. So I have 4 portrait pages and 1 landscape page. If I wanted to go back to portrait, I need another section break and then flip it back to portrait. Okay?
Can you put them in the middle? You can do like,
yes.
And you change the landscape?
Sure. So if I put in another section break here, okay, and then in this one, I go back to portrait. Like that? Okay. The other thing that's very nice with this is I'm going to put in columns. Hi, welcome, you're not late. Okay. So I can do 3 columns. It's very nice. It you know, breaks things up. Okay. If I wanted this column to start at the top of the next column, I'm going to put in a column break. And then the header will start here. Okay. You know, I was playing around with that indentation. These are bullets. So now they've picked up that indentation. Sorry, I'm zooming out. Okay, this is a bulleted list. That's why that was more indented. But let's say I wanted this part to start at the top of the next column. I force a column break. Okay. So if you're doing any kind of newsletters, this is how you do it. Okay. All right, hi, come on in. You're not late. Have a seat. There's one there, there's one here. Welcome. Okay, so I'm out of time on Word. Are we good? Any last questions before I leave Word? Did you learn something?
Yeah.
Yay. All right. I'm happy. So now, one of my favorite.
Yeah, I guess I do have a question. What, sure. Is there a difference between the format? Because I've got a document that went like from an older version to a new version. Now I'm